grace of God, well, no doctor can leave me. If I'm buried neath the sod, well, angels won't see me. Let me go, boys. Let me go, boys. Let me go down in the mud. Rivers all run dry. Is ours was the proud land of her fathers, belonged to us and them, not any of the others. Let them go, boys. Let them go, boys. Let them go down in the mud. Rivers all run dry.
Because I think Shane McGowan's one of the best songwriters on the planet, and nobody can fucking understand it when he sings it. So now, if I could just get all of us to understand this song. Huh?
Bizzle in the tenor store, tenor store. I was 13, thought I was the finest I ever had seen. Asked the back of heaven, so now when I grew up, mama dropped a dozen that you really blew up, really blew up. Didn't understand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand, devil's right hand, the devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand. Pistols, a cap and ball coat. Shoot us out of line, let's load them out slow. Load them out slow. Send them by that. Get you into trouble, she can't get you out. Then I went down a silver cold 45. Called a peacemaker, but never knew why. Never knew why. Didn't understand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand. Devil's right hand. The devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand. Devil's right hand. Devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand. Woo! I got into a car game in a cupboard. Shut the door down, watching down the fire. Never touch his hopes, I never had a chance to try. Tried a moment and I took me in a bed. I smiled, pleaded not guilty. I said not guilty, I said. Got the wrong man, nothing touch a trigger but the devil's right hand. Devil's right hand, devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is the devil's right hand. The devil's right hand, the devil's right hand. Nothing touch a trigger but the devil's right hand. Mama says is a pistol is a devil's right hand.
Thank you.
just a 7 Chevy, she low and sleek and black. Someday I'll put her on that interstate and never look back. Someday I'll finally let go, cause I know there's a better way. No, no, it's over that rainbow. I'm gonna get high again
an alimony check at a liquor store, I'll get a beautiful sign. This one never did anything wrong, but Mary Kay, she was way better than average for songs.
somewhere there. Sure, I made you cry. So I can't remember if we said goodbye. One place I may never go in my life again. Was I off somewhere or just too high? We said goodbye.
To the chick song portion of the program. I write these songs on purpose, and I have as long as I've been doing this, because it's like I grew up in Texas and I didn't play football, so this was my only shot. And I was a pain in the ass that tipped my guitar at every party I ever went to. And it's, you know, my first audiences were pretty much exclusively between 3 and 5 girls. And I would, you know, I knew a lot of Rolling Stone songs and Bob Dylan songs, but the truth is that Mick Jagger and Bob Dylan scared the fuck out of 14-year-old girls. So I learned a lot of Donovan songs, man, and because it worked. And it was like, it became sort of a template for the rest of my life and career. I still write these songs. I am not above, like, repurposing a song I wrote for one girl, using it on another girl. They are my songs, after all. I've actually heard women argue about which song is about who, and I never have the heart to tell them. They're all about me. Even this one. Everyone knows she's fine. She blesses all that she sees, tops of her hair and a kiss in the breeze. But she don't love no one but me. I can't believe she's mine. Shiver and she moves, tell I'm all the mound up. Even when she's blue, and shine, everyone knows she's fine. My baby swings down the street, big tall high heel shoes on her feet. Walks by, my heart skips a beat, stumbling like a fool. And she give me something so sweet, I can't sleep, y'all, I can't eat. Spots fly whenever we meet, breathless cause she's so cool. Two kinds of music. There's the blues and there's zippity doo dah. This ain't zippity doo dah. Just fine.
street, I swear. He lives right down on Lewis Street, I swear. I seen him rocking in his rocking chair. I start way up the top of Lewis Street and walk down to the end. Start way up top and walk down to the end. Go way down in the bottom, y'all, and come back up again. My mama told me Bible too, they both talked leg tongue blue, but got them old South Nashville blues again. Can't be satisfied until they wind me up again.
Big ass 12 string guitar is really for. This hymn.
Hey. Everybody call an angel, see the stranger to the devil I know. His mark is on the body and fiber in her soul. And making love, he's laughing at us down below. She's the devil I know, devil I know. She's the devil I know. I said you come heaven, but an angel is the devil I know. She's the devil I know. She's the kind of woman that'll keep you coming back for more. Got the kind of face you swear you've seen someplace before. It could have been your mama and it could have been a Mexican whore. She's the devil I know, devil I know. She's the devil I know. I said you're come heaven, but an angel is the devil I know. She's the devil. Yeah, yeah. She'd drive me straight to hell, I'm telling her, I think I'll just go. Well, the devil's in here to deliver me body and soul. And every inch she dragged me down, I'm closer to the glow. She's the devil, yeah, she's the devil I know. She's the devil I know. Oh, says you come heaven, boy, angel is the devil I know. She's the devil. Yeah, she's the devil I know. She's the devil I know. I say you come heaven, but her angel is the devil I know. She's the devil I know.
I did make a couple of records, or three records in the last few years. You know, that's what I do normally. I write a record and record it and go out and tour to support that record. And in 2019, I wrote and recorded a record, and then that didn't happen because nobody went fucking anywhere for a while. So we released it in 2020. It's, you know, I made one record of songs I wrote and two records of songs that I didn't, and I want to play a little bit from all of those. The record that I wrote was called Ghosts of West Virginia, and it was most of the songs that were written for a play called Coal Country, which I worked on for 4 years with Jessica Blank and Eric Jensen. We went to Montcoal, West Virginia, Beckley, that area and interviewed the survivors of an explosion that happened in a coal mine there about 14 years ago now. Worst mining disaster in this country since the 70s. Killed 29 guys. Now, that was the first non-union mine on that mountain. And that's not a fucking accident. That is what trade unions do, y'all. They protect locals. So these guys, and it was the families of the people that didn't make it and some guys that were there that day, and we wanted to tell their story. So we worked on it for a long time. I wrote the songs and I made the record. And then the play went up after 4 years work on March 3rd, 2020 at the Public Theater in New York, which means we closed 10 days later on the 13th with every other theater in New York. But we did get it back up again. After the world sort of halfway came back. And we were grateful for that because we wanted to tell those people's stories. The folks who are portrayed in the show, every word that's spoken in the play comes out of the mouths of the people that lived it. I had a little more leeway with the songs. But now, that explosion at Upper Big Ranch was national news for about 30 seconds. If you were up really early in the morning, on the morning after, you'd have seen the networks and the cable channels out there talking to anybody that would talk to them. You would have definitely heard from a gentleman called Tommy Davis, because Tommy was there that day. He'd just come up top when it blew. And in that instant, Tommy lost his firstborn son, his big brother, and his nephew. So Tommy was angry. Tommy was talking, because Tommy wanted answers. Look me in the eyes when you're talking to me. Wanna see any simple way to lie? Don't try and tell me that you couldn't foresee what everybody reckons was a matter of time. Goddamn right, I'm emotional. I ain't nothing but a man. Hell yes, it's personal. Before you leave here, you're gonna understand. It's about fathers. It's about sons. It's about lovers waking up in the middle of the night alone. It's about muscle. It's about bone. It's about a river running thicker than water. And it's about blood. Once upon a time in America, working man knew where he stood. Nowadays, just getting by is a miracle. Probably wouldn't give it up if I could. Try and tell me about the state of the economy, fiscal reality, profit and loss. None of that matters when you're underground anyway. Damn sure you can't tell me nothing about cost. It's about fathers. It's about sons. It's about lovers waking up in the middle of a night alone. It's about muscle. It's about bone. It's about a river running thicker than water. And it's about blood. Tell yourself it was an accident, isolated incident, part of the job. Yeah, well, tell that to the families, kids without daddies, tell it to God. Something when you hear howling through the holler of the ghost of a widow that cried for every man that died for a coke on the dollar, lung full of dust and a heart full of lies. It's about fathers. It's about sons. It's about lovers waking up in the middle of a night alone. It's about muscle. It's about bone. It's about a river running thicker than water. It's about blood. It's about Pee Wee Acord, Jason Atkins, Chris Bell, Greg Brock, Kenny Chapman, Robert E. Clark, Timmy Davis, Corey Davis, Michael Lee Ellswick, William L. Griffin, Stephen Hara, Dean Jones, Richard K. Lane,
Roosevelt, Lynch, Nicholas Darrell McCroskey, Joe Markham, Otto Lee Maynard, Eddie Mooney, Adam Morgan, Rex Mullins, Joshua Knapper, Boone Payne, Dewey Persinger, Jody Price, Stuart Scott, Gary Wayne Corbin, Grover Dale Steens, Billy Willingham, Ricky Workman. It's about blood.
A couple of records, like I said, I didn't write. And one of them was a record of Jerry Jeff Walker songs. We lost Jerry Jeff kind of at the height of the lockdown, so we couldn't do much at first. And then when we finally got where we could, I was honored to be asked to come and sing my old man at the graveside. And myself, Keith Sykes, who's here tonight, Emma Lou Harris, Jeff Hanna, a lot of folks got together at Luckenbach and we sang Jerry Jeff songs all night. And I decided that what I needed to do, I made the Towns record, I made the Guy record, I had to make the Jerry Jeff record. So I got Susan and Django and Jesse's blessings that night, and I went to work. I didn't have to learn very many of these songs. I've been singing this song since I was 14 years old. I learned it for a play I did during my short career in high school. I knew about Jerry Jeff long before he moved to Texas. My drama teacher gave me his first album, and I learned a song from it, and I sang it in that play, and I became famous for this song at my high school. I sang it every time I unpacked the guitar along with all those Donovan songs. Until I was 19 years old, and I met Jerry Jeff Walker, and I kind of had to quit singing it. My favorite thing about this project, I think, is that I get to sing this song again. You can sing it too, and I'll bet you know it. New man Bojangles in the dancing queue. Worn out shoes. Silver hair, ragged shirt, and bag of pants. It jumps so high, jumps so high. That'll light the touchdown. I met a man who said in New Orleans I was down and out. Looked to me to be the very eyes of age. Spoke right out. He talked to the life, talked to life. Life and slap his leg a step. He said the name Bojangles and danced the lake across the cell. Grabbed his pants, no better stance than a jump so high. And he clicked his heels. Let go and laugh, let go and laugh. Shook his clothes back all around. Come on.
can't hear you. Mr. Bojangles, there you go. Mr. Bojangles,
quite 3 years ago, we lost a great singer-songwriter, and I lost my firstborn son, who I love more than anything else in this world, and that's a hole that I get to walk around for the rest of my life, and there's not anything anybody can do to spare me that, and nobody's supposed to do that. They'll say, I've heard people say that the one thing you're not supposed to have to do is bury a child, but the truth is, that's kind of bullshit. Somebody's doing it every day. Somebody's doing it right now. And so I try not to think of it that way. The only good I can find in it, I mean, I have to do what I have to do. I'm going to be okay because I have John Henry to take care of, and I got stuff I need to do. So I have to just go on, and that's good. That's the way that works. What you could do for me, I think, is to hear me. And the only good I can find in it is to be able to stand up here and say this. Justin died of an overdose of fentanyl. He did not use opiates. It was in an 8-ball of cocaine that he bought. Now, it's out there. It's in everything. Now, I know what an 8-ball of cocaine looks like. And I saw it, and there was a better part of an 8-ball in his pocket, 3 lines on the table. He took got about 1 step towards the bathroom, and he fell on the floor. So that means he went down on the first bump. So what you can do for me is to hear me when I say it's out there. It's fucking dangerous. So be careful. And sing this song with me.
show us how now. Water is wide, milk and honey on the other side. Water is wide, milk and honey on the other side. Water is wide, milk and honey on the other side. Keep on traveling. That sucks. You're gonna do better than that.
Thank you.
come home. And I ask you now, tell me what would you do if her eyes were black and her hair was blue? Cause I've traveled around, I've been over this world, ain't never seen nothing like how we girl.
Thank you so much.
Billy Austin. I'm 29 years old. I was born in Oklahoma, quarter Cherokee, I'm told. Don't remember Oklahoma. Been so long since I left home. It's like I've always been in prison. Like I've always been alone. Didn't mean to hurt nobody. Never thought I'd cross the line. I held up a filling station like I'd done 100 times. Get done like I told him. He lay face down on the floor. Guess I'll never know what made me turn and walk back through that door. Rang out like thunder. My ears rang like a bell. No one come running, so I just called the cops myself. It took a time to get there, and I believe I could run. I knew I should be feeling something, but I never shed till. Make the papers, cause I only killed one man. But my trial was over quickly, and then the long hard wait began. My court appointed lawyer could not look me in the eye. Just a lap, closed briefcase when they sentenced me to die. Now my week's over as the final eye drags by. I won't stand here and tell you that I don't to die. There's 9 or 7 men here, mostly black, brown, we're all poor. Most of us are guilty, and who are you to say for sure? So when a preacher comes to get me, shave off all my hair. Could you take that long walk with me, knowing hell was waiting there? Could you pull that switch yourself, sir, with a sure and steady hand, and go home and tell yourself, sir, you're better than I am. Name is Bill Austin. I'm 29 years old. I was born. I'm told.
Thank you so much. I haven't quit writing songs. There will be, I don't know when the next record's coming. What I'm working on now is myself and Daisy Foote, whose father was Horton Foote. Horton Foote was a playwright and a screenwriter. He wrote the screenplay for a movie called Tender Mercies that you might have seen. Horton's been gone for some years, but Daisy and I, for the last couple of years, have been working on a musical of Tender Mercies, and that's it's going pretty well. It's kind of Broadway tracked, and so that like I said, theater takes a long time. So I'll figure something out about a record, but right now I'm working on that. I haven't quit writing songs. I do want to say this, and I've kind of been saying this a lot lately. I think that we've reached a point in the history of this country that after all we've been through the last several years, the COVID thing, and we even found a way that should have united us. That everybody was in the same boat, and it did the opposite, which freaked me out a little bit. But that's just because of where we are. We've reached a point where we don't listen to each other anymore. It's a big country. People live a lot of different ways. My political beliefs haven't changed a fucking bit. I'm a radical motherfucker. But at the same time, if you can't have a conversation with somebody that you know you're going to fundamentally disagree with at the beginning of that conversation, then democracy can't fucking happen. We have to learn to talk and listen to each other. So y'all take care of each other and listen to each other, and we'll see you down the road. Hey girl, don't bother and lock your door. Singing that same old song that I always sang before. He lies so hard, caught you below. Hey girl, figure out which is which. Well, for I die Romeo, you son of a bitch. But you just as soon fight a switch. What? Come on, make love on your side. Way up on your living room floor. He's the last of the high court you the doors. He's the last thing I'll not do right. Sam needs a wind of daylight. He's the last of the high court you the doors. Just passing through, I didn't you? Just say this is the last time, baby, like you always did before. Be the last of the high court you know.